Good evening, and thank you for joining us this evening. My name is Cindy Lawrence. I'm the Executive Director and the CEO of the National Museum of Mathematics. Thank you. So tonight we're celebrating mathematics and MoMath through the lens of sports. Being on a team is, of course, as American as apple pie. It teaches one not just how to lead, but how to follow. How to be both a gracious winner and a good loser. How to build strength and skills to strategize and to collaborate. Well, mathematics is not so different. We all start out as students in a classroom with teachers as our leaders, our role models, and our cheerleaders. Let us take a moment to think about the teachers who inspired us, who in a sense served as our team coaches, challenging us to reach higher, to stretch and exercise our minds, and to build our intellectual capacity to discover. To the math teachers who are here with us tonight, as well as to the organizations that support them, we salute you. But many people think of math as a solitary endeavor, one that involves working alone, pencil and paper, computers, and of course, for a true professional, coffee, as our only companions. If there's any competitive aspect at all, it's one-on-one. Students vying for the top score and a selective college admission, or mathematicians striving to discover innovative methods of attack, develop new insights, and solve thorny problems. I might have thought of math this way too, before MoMath came along. But math is not a solitary endeavor. Like any worthwhile field of study, it is furthered through rich discourse, thoughtful consideration of competing ideas, and collaboration. It is enriched when we think of ourselves as being part of a team, when our work can serve as a stepping stone for others, and when we can all celebrate a new breakthrough together. It is my belief that MoMath has become and will remain a nexus for mathematical learning, discovery, and joy. That it will continue to provide a place where both those who love math and those who fear it can come together to experience something wonderful. That the almost 1 million people who have walked through our doors since the museum opened 6 years ago, the almost 2 million who have experienced a MoMath event, exhibit, or program, and even the more than 17 million who viewed the recent MoMath video on BuzzFeed have all been inspired by something they have seen. I'd like to recognize a very important team tonight. MoMath's Board of Trustees serve as coaches, referees, owners, and managers, and even sometimes pinch hitters. They volunteer their time, their resources, their wisdom, and the museum simply would not exist without their ongoing efforts and support. Please rise so we can all thank you. I'd also like to thank the members of our advisory council who serve as advisors and mentors to the museum, providing an ongoing source of inspiration, friendship, and of course, expert math advice. And then there's the MoMath staff, the best team of people I've ever had the pleasure to know, and without whom this entire evening would not have been possible. To each of you, my heartfelt thanks. But I've left one team out. It's the spectators, the people who pour into the stadiums week after week, month after month, year after year, to root on their favorite team, injecting enthusiasm, spirit, and excitement into each and every game. Tonight, thanks to the generosity of so many table sponsors, we have a full house. and everyone here is part of the team. If you believe that engaging the public with mathematics is a worthwhile endeavor, if you believe that our nation will be stronger with a mathematically literate populace, and if you believe in the importance of mathematics aesthetically, educationally, and intellectually, then you are part of the team. Thank you for filling our stands tonight with your enthusiastic support. I'm delighted now to bring up a dear friend of mine and of the museum's, Pete Muller, who will delight us all with a musical tribute to John Urschel.